Faces, it's 6 o'clock. Time for Family Feud. Now, here's your host, Grant Denyer.
Joining us here on Family Feud, right now two families are standing by to take their shot at a bucket load of cash, and all they have to do is guess how 100 strangers answered our survey questions. It couldn't be easier. So let's meet them now. First up, welcome back our champs, the Hodge family. Maddie, night one, you came, you took home $10,000. Yay!
It's pretty nice.
Who'd you do it with?
My lovely boyfriend, Jacob.
Lovely.
My favourite auntie, Lucy.
Lovely.
And my dad, Jason.
Great to see you guys back and ready to take them on tonight, the Hyatt family. Hey, Anne. Good to see you. Who've you brought with you?
I've got my brother, Damien, my lovely wife, Amanda, and my sister-in-law, Chelsea.
Welcome, 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 welcome. Right, team captains, let's play the feud. We surveyed 100 people and the top 8 answers are on the board. Name a food you have almost every day. Aaron.
Bread.
Bread. Bread. Hey, Matt.
How are you,
Lovely to see you, Damien. Great to have you with us.
Thanks.
The Hyatt name, does that have some advantages? Like, because if you're staying in hotels, man, that's written on the building.
It is a well-known name in the hotel industry. We did use it once when Chelsea and I went on the honeymoon. We went to New York and we actually slipped the name and got upgraded to the penthouse for a full week. A beautiful little spot in Manhattan. So, yeah, it
yes.
was great.
So, well done to you two. Good on you for exploiting it. Name a food you have almost every day, Damien.
Every day I make sure I have at least a piece of fruit.
Fruit is good. You should.
You're right. Yep.
Nice. How are you, Amanda?
Good, thanks.
Lovely to have you with us. A food you have almost every day?
Meat.
Meat.
Yeah.
Good. Hi, Chelsea.
Hi, Grant.
Welcome.
Thank you.
How about you?
I would have to say vegetables.
Vegetables?
Yes.
Aaron, great start. Just quietly, you've been on The Feud before, yeah?
I have, yeah. I think it was about 6 or 7 years ago the four of us were on Bert's Family Feud.
Yeah, right. Yes. How did you go?
3 nights. Got zip. Nothing. Nothing. Yes.
So the retirement plan didn't exactly come off, so now you're back to fix that.
Back to try again. Yes.
Lovely. Good to have you back.
Thank you.
Name a food you have almost every day.
Dairy.
Dairy?
Yeah.
Let's try it. First try. No drama. Damien?
Yeah, I'm not sure if you call it a food or a drink, but every day I make sure I have lots of water. So I'm going to try
water. Name a food you have almost every day. Damien says water. Let's try it. Second strike. Righto, the Hodge family could steal. Amanda?
I pretty much eat these most mornings. Eggs?
Eggs?
Yeah.
Nice. Good thinking. Chelsea?
My kids eat sandwiches every day.
Sandwiches
so
every day?
Sandwiches.
That's not bad. Let's try it. Afraid not. Over to the Hodge family. Jason, what do you think?
I think milk.
Lucy?
Milk.
Jacob?
An apple a day keeps the doctor away, Grant.
Maddie? Sensible option, Jacob?
Well, majority rules, so I'm going to go with milk.
We're going with milk, say the Hodge family. No, afraid not. Points go to the Hodge. Of course. So it's 53 points to the Hyatt family, and if either family win for 5 nights in a row, they'll be driving home the brand new Mitsubishi Outlander. The Outlander, it seats 5 with features including Mitsubishi's multi-communication system, dusk sensing headlamps, and CVT auto with paddle shift. And for everybody playing along at home, I want the top answer to this. Name something people get personalised. When we come back, we'll share answers. See you in a moment. A ball here tonight. I hope you are too. Now, before the break, I asked, name something people get personalised, and the top answer was
number plates.
Nothing cooler than having the number plate, I am cool. Now you know my number plate. Jacob, Damien, let's play.
It's not really. It was just a joke.
We surveyed 100 people and the top 8 answers are on the board. Name something a child might do to get out of eating their veggies. Jacob?
Chuck a tantrum.
They chuck a tanty. Damien?
I'll say they cry.
Let's have a look. Nice work, Hyatt. So, you're in Paris and you decided to dress up, what, in theme. What happened?
We were on a tour on our honeymoon and it was pouring with rain, so we had to get a backup set of clothes, and we went to what was equivalent to our Target over there.
Which would be Target. Legit over there, because it's French.
We went in there looking for the cheapest outfit we could find. We went our separate ways, got to the checkout, and we had matching tracksuits.
Awkward.
We climbed the Eiffel Tower in matching tracksuits and have the photos to prove it.
Wow. So. You guys wouldn't look like tourists at all. That's cute, though. That's cute. Something a child might do to get out of eating their veggies.
Hide.
Can't find me, Mum. Can't make me eat them if you can't find me. First strike. Chelsea.
I think they would play. Continue to play.
Continue to just play. Second strike. Hodge family gets set to steal. Aaron.
Well, we probably go through this nearly every morning at breakfast. My two young boys throw their food, so tip it up.
You feed them vegetables at breakfast?
Well, I'm sorry, dinner time.
Yeah. Let's try it. Throw them away. Keeps you in the game. Damien.
I was just thinking about our children as well, and sometimes when we're trying to feed them, they'll actually run away from us.
So they'll just disappear.
Yeah, just run.
Just gone. Get out of here. I'm leaving. Three strikes. It's proving a difficult one. Jason.
Already had enough. Full.
Full? Good. Lucy.
I was going to go with full too.
Jacob.
I used to hide them.
Where would you hide them?
Behind the curtain. On the final one she was cleaning.
That's a really good discovery for her. Maddie, yours to choose.
I think I'm going to go with hide the veggies.
Hide sounds fun. Is it on the board? Yes, Hutch family! Welcome to the game! Number 7. Wow. Two full, good. Give them to the dog. All 7 sit. We have just equipped children all over this country how to get out of now eating their vegetables. We've just given them like a whole manual on how to get out of eating their vegetables. 41 to 53, the Hyatts have it at the moment. Double points time. Give me Lucy, give me Amanda. Let's play. Parents around the country just cursing us right now. We surveyed 100 people and the top 5 answers are on the board. Name something that has a particularly long nose. Amanda.
Pinocchio.
Pinocchio does. Well done. Very good. You guys are smashing the top answer at the podium. Name something that has a particularly long nose.
I'd go with anteater.
Anteater. Yeah. Yes. Aaron.
A long nose, thinking a witch.
Let's try witch. No. Let's try. Damien.
Well, some dogs have very long noses, so we'll have a go for a dog.
A long-nosed dog.
Mm.
Second strike. Hodges can steal. You're currently leading, Amanda. Keep it this way by knocking out a few more for me. Name something that has a particularly long nose.
I'm thinking a dolphin.
Might yeah.
Think it's a nose, but it could be a beak.
Long snout sort of thing.
Yeah.
What about a dolphin? No. Third strike, Hyatt. Hodge family, Jason.
I would say an elephant.
Yeah! I like that.
Welcome to the show, Jason. Lucy.
Echidna.
Echidna's good too, Jacob.
A horse has a long nose? Maybe. Face?
Long. Oh, it doesn't remind me of a joke. What a long face. Maddie.
I think I'm going to go with elephant.
Elephant. Yeah. Totally makes sense. Can we put you guys in front with elephant? Giraffe! Echidna is also there. Wonderful options. 187. The Hodge family has it at the moment from 53. The Hyatt's still playing very well, though. Look, if you can't get enough of Family Feud, then head to 10 Play, where you can catch some very funny moments from the show. Plus, you can also play along with our official Family Feud game. Head to 10 Play and all the details are there. Triple points when we come back on The Feud. Particularly wonderful time tonight. 187, the Hodges lead at the moment, but I've got a feeling the Hyatts are making a comeback. They've been on The Feud before. They won nothing in three nights. Maybe tonight is the night. So hang in there, everybody. It's the family gets the 300 points in this round. Could take home $10,000. And we're playing for triple points now, Hyatts. All right, let's hit it. Jason, Chelsea, let's go. We surveyed 100 people and the top six answers are on the board. Apart from people, name something you'd find in the back of an ambulance. Gee, that was close. Jason.
Oxygen.
Oxygen. Nice. Jesse.
What's that? Paramedic.
A paramedic. No. Pass or play?
Play.
Play.
Play. Play. Play. Play. Play.
Apart from people, name something you'd find in the back of an ambulance. Maddie.
The bed, the trolley bed.
Let's see. Yes. Yeah. Apart from people, name something you find in the back of an ambulance.
A defibrillator.
What is it again?
A defibrillator.
Well done.
A zapper.
A revival machine.
That's the one. You know what I'm talking about.
The defib. Yep. Yeah.
Let's see.
A blanket.
A blanket to stay warm. First strike, Jason.
I think just equipment, medical equipment.
Nice and general. Okay. No, second strike. Hyatt's good steal, so they're having a think. Maddie. Apart from people, name something you'd find in the back of an ambulance.
Thinking medicine.
Is medicine there? Yeah. Oh, good. Jacob?
She stole it, Grant.
Uh-oh.
Stole it.
Got something else?
Wheels.
Wheels in the ambulance go. Third strike. It's over to the Hyatts. Whoa! Chelsea.
If you have an accident, I think you'd need a bandage.
Yeah. Amanda?
I'm thinking... blood in the back of an ambulance.
Ooh.
Not nice, but
yeah. Be there. Okay, fairly accurate. Damien.
Yeah, I was thinking the blood as well.
Aaron, yours to choose.
Yeah, I'm going to go with the blood as well.
Going with the blood.
Yep.
Bring you guys back into this game. Is blood on the board? No, blood on the board. Hodges become our champions again, and we'll play for another $10,000. This is what we're looking for, Hyatt family. Two tries. Chelsea. Two decades. And no wins. Look, we won't send you home empty-handed because that would be so cruel after you've had two tries in two different decades. We're going to give you guys a $1,000 Wish gift card to be shared between you. The card can be redeemed at Woolworths Supermarkets, Masters Home Improvement, Big W and other participating stores. And you'll also be taking home our Family Feud board game available at Toys R Us, Games World and Mind Games. Really good try. Really good try. Hodge family, fast money, who's doing it? The kids are.
Why? Because they were a winning force last night. You're heading back to our soundproof booth, which is back that way. You know how this goes now. Let's turn 10 into 20.
Hope so.
Next on the Feud. Don't miss Fast Money.
Family Feud is on Facebook and Twitter. Plus, you can find us on YouTube and catch all the action on 10Play.
Welcome back. It's Fast Money time here on The Feud. So let's see if the Hodge family can again win some cash. If you and Jacob get turner points or more between you, you'll win another $10,000 and take the tally to $20,000. Jacob is now in our soundproof booth and can't hear your answers. He loves a dance. I'm going to ask you five questions, going to give you 20 seconds to answer. If you pass, we'll come back at this time, and the clock starts at the end of the first question. You ready?
Alrighty.
20 seconds on the clock, please. Good luck, Maddie. Name a profession where laughing would be frowned upon.
Lawyer.
Name a boring household chore.
Sweeping.
Name something you'd prefer to do with a friend than do alone.
Pass.
Besides a bike, name something a child might ride.
Toy car.
Name a past or present Australian swimmer.
Liesl Giants.
Name something you'd prefer to do... Out of time, I'm afraid. Out of time. Name a profession where laughing would be frowned upon. You said...
Lawyer. He's guilty, Your Honour.
That would be really creepy. Survey says... 14. What a boring household chore, you said. Sweeping is, survey says, 12. Something you prefer to do with a friend than do alone. You did not answer in time, therefore... 0 points, I'm afraid. Besides a bike, name something a child might ride. You said, toy car, survey says... Oh, no, this is not a good round at the moment. Name a past or present Australian swimmer. You said? Liesl Jones. Survey says. Oh. Ow! 26, Maddie. You want that? Well done last night. Not so well now. Head back to family. Clear the board. Jacob. Woo! Cool. Not cool. Not cool at all. You need to get 174 points to get $10,000. So, yeah, you with me?
Yep.
You with me? I'm going to ask you the same five questions, but as you're the second player, it's a little harder. It's way harder. So I'll give you an extra 5 seconds. Yeah, now, if you pass on a question, I'll ask it again if there's time. And if you repeat an answer that's already there, and that's quite highly unlikely, you'll hear this sound. And I'll ask you to try again. That's so right. Can we remind everybody of Maddie's answers? And 25 seconds on the clock too, please. Time starts from the end of the first question, big fella. Good luck. Name a profession where laughing would be frowned upon.
The judge.
Name a boring household chore.
Cleaning.
Name something you'd prefer to do with a friend than do alone.
Pass.
Name, besides a bike, name something a child might ride. A
pram.
Name a past or present Australian swimmer.
Yeah, pass.
Name something you'd prefer to do with a friend than
pass.
Do alone. Name a
Green
past or present Australian... Good, name a... Oh, no!
I couldn't pass anymore! I couldn't read any faster!
I think we've got it. I think we've got $10,000. Some days are diamonds, some days are stones.
Yeah, I agree with that.
Is this one a diamond or a stone?
It's a rock. Rock bottom.
Name a profession where laughing would be frowned upon. You said a judge. Survey says 9. Okay, not too bad. Funeral director was the top answer. Maddie had the second top answer of lawyer. So we need 165 points now for $10,000. Name a boring household chore, you said. Cleaning, not bad. Survey says 7. Dishes was the top answer. Vacuuming, second top answer. Name something you'd prefer to do with a friend than do alone. You giggled, young man.
I believe I passed.
Did you? I believe you passed too, and I believe in the
presence of your girlfriend's family, that was probably a wise decision. So you said nada, therefore 0 points. Top answer was movies. Or shopping. Besides a bike, name something a child might ride. You said... Woo! This pram! This pram is awesome! Woo! Oh,
you that well.
Are you regretting the pram? That was the first thing you said when we finished was, oh, pram, why'd I say that?
There's not much else going on, Grant. Oh. Scooter?
Well, let's just see what this answer is first.
Oh. Shocking.
Ouch. Funnily enough, the top answer was...
Scooter.
There you go. Easy in hindsight, isn't it? So we now need 158 from this final answer. Name a past or present Australian swimmer. You passed about 47 times on this, but we eventually got something out of you. You said, Grant Hackett. Feels good. Is 158 in it?
Not quite.
Survey says, 9. Ian Thorpe was the top answer, Jacob. And that was a record-breaking round. That was, in fact, the lowest score we've ever had in Family Feud history. So, thankfully, they won some money last night. Maybe they will again tomorrow night, but they do get $10 for every fast money point, so that gives them about 98 cents. The project's coming up next. I'm Grant Denyer. We'll see you tomorrow night.